You know, I've always been a bit of a romantic. Of course, these days, the last bastion of true romance is on pay-per-view. Yeah. You don't find it in the streets anymore. You gotta pay for it. Yeah, the other day I was watching this, Love Fest, where, couples were, put in a circle. You know, a daisy chain, but a sort of a hunched daisy chain, and their wrists and their ankles were shackled together in a circle, and except the last two people in the chain, you know, they had to hold on to each other. See, so they held on to each other, and everybody else was finger banging each other. It was just. It was romantic, and so everybody's finger banging each other, and then the announcer tells them to switch positions, you know, like a square dance with your partner, and so, you know, out come the fingers, and then into the next one, and the thing is, the two people at the end who aren't chained to each other are just holding on for dear life. You know, everybody else is just squirming, and a couple of people, you know, you lose your balance, and losing your balance is a default point, and they're just holding on. You know, everybody is just tumbling down, and it looks like, you know, some sort of octopus at the end. And it's just beautiful. You know, it's just you don't find that kind of romance out in the streets anymore. You don't, and it's a shame. You know, back when I was younger, you could look behind some bushes and see something like that. But now, it's going to cost you $19.95 on a Saturday night. Romance, the era of romance. Here's another example. You know, back when I was a kid, you could just take your car and go to Lover's Lane and see some of the most death-defying acrobatic fellatio you'd ever want to see. But now, pay-per-view again. You know, now, pay-per-view, you gotta watch the Suckfest if you really want love and romance. And the Suckfest is within a boxing ring, you know, and it's these knee pad girls. And they're just, you know, the lines through the door, you know, and it's not just guys, it's donkeys and all sorts of stuff, you know, one after the other. And it's a beautiful gesture of love and romance, you know, Harlequin-esque, Victorian romance. You just don't see in the streets anymore. When I was younger, you know, you could go into a high school gymnasium during off hours when classes weren't in session, and you could see that. Now, $24.95 Friday nights. Hey, one more example, if you don't mind. When I was younger, all you had to do, if you were in school, I mean, if you were lucky enough not to be in school, well, here's one of the things you missed out on. If you paid the principal $50, it varied, you know, region to region. When I was a kid, it was $50. If you paid the principal $50, she'd let you into the teacher's lounge during off hours, you know, where everybody else is either writing I will not pick my nose in class on the board 100 times or out clapping the erasers. The kids who had $50 were in the teacher's lounge watching the teachers. Ooh, all the things the teachers would do. And of course, you know, they would enhance their income with the money. Nowadays, if you want that kind of sentimental romance and good, honest, softcore love, $30, pay-per-view, Sundays, Day of the Lord. Because they're teachers, you know. On pay-per-view, Sunday, Day of the Lord, teachers, to make extra money, they just go at each other. And I mean protractors and rulers and big erasers and dry erase markers and pencils and, like, orifices crammed with writing supplies. You know, if you're into that kind of romance, if you're into that kind of good old-fashioned, honest love, which I am, you can't find a more romantic person than me, unless you're willing to pay a lot, and then it's just for one night. So yeah, romance these days, it's not what it used to be. It's just not. And that's bad.